Welcome students, this is Dheeraj Kumar Sahu representing the topic prerequisites of IC engine that is in the syllabus of 4th semester diploma engineering mechanical engineering students in the subject thermal engineering 2. So let's begin. So in the content we have what is engine, what are the components of engine, how many types of engines are there, technical terms, processes inside the engine, working and what will happen if we put diesel in bikes, or that means if we put diesel in petrol engine, what will happen, and if we put petrol in truck, what will happen. So the first one is what is engine. Engine means it is a machine or device that converts one form of energy to another form, that may be electrical energy to other engine, that may be. So our energy is there, that may be mechanical energy to heat energy. Okay, so we do an engine usually convert the thermal energy, that is heat energy, to mechanical energy. So mechanical energy is being generated by the use of engine. So if we consider thermal energy to mechanical energy, hence it is called heat energy, heat engine. So heat engine is a device that converts thermal energy or heat energy to mechanical energy. These are the components of engine, in which we have inlet valve. The inlet valve, it is the component through which the fuel and air is going to enter inside the engine. There is also an exhaust valve or exhaust manifold. Inlet valve is the controlling agent of this inlet manifold. The inlet path is controlled by inlet valve, and the exhaust valve is controlling the exhaust manifold. So the path, this is the path of entry of air and fuel through which it will be taken inside the engine cylinder, and this is the part through which it will be removed. The burn product, the combustion product, will be removed. So now this is the piston. There is a component called piston that will move up and down. Let me explain the term. The topmost portion through which this piston can go, this will be this square or rectangle component will go up and down. So the upper portion through which the piston can go, it is known as TDC. TDC, top dead center. The bottom portion, the bottommost portion that can, up to which it can go, is known as bottom dead center. So the piston, and there is a connecting rod. Piston is connected to the rotating element called crank through a rod called connecting rod. So now the crank is the rotating element. The upside movement, up down movement, is converted into rotational movement by this connecting rod, taking the motion from piston to crank. All the other are the also important components. So based on engine, based on different criteria, we have different types of engine. So if we consider the combustion process, if inside the engine the fuel is burned, then it is called internal combustion engine. If it is burned outside the engine, then it is called external combustion engine. Internal combustion engines are normal vehicle engines. If it is burned outside the engine, then it is external combustion engine, like gas turbine. So if we consider the ignition system means by the process by which the fuel is going to burn is known as ignition system. So if we are having a spark inside the engine to burn the fuel, then it is known as spark ignition. If there is no spark and we are compressing the fuel, this is the chamber and we are using the fuel and it is compressed to a small space and it is ignited, then it is known as compression ignition. Normally spark ignition means petrol engine and compression ignition means diesel engine. Based on the stroke, what is stroke now? Now the पिस्टन, पिस्टन इज मूविंग फ्रॉम टॉप डेड सेंटर टू बॉटम डेड सेंटर. सो द लीनियर डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टीडीसी टू बीडीसी इज नोन एज स्ट्रोक. सो इफ द इंजिन completes four stroke for the complete processes, then it is four stroke engine. If there are only two movement, then it is two stroke engine. Based on the number of cylinders, how many cylinders are used in the engine, we may call it single cylinder. If there is only one cylinder, if there are more than one cylinder, then it is called as multi cylinder engine. Now the operating cycle, if it operates, the engine fuel is operating on a cycle named as Otto cycle, constant volume cycle, diesel cycle, constant pressure cycle, then they are named so. Now the technical terms, TDC as we have already done. What is TDC? Bottom dead center, it is also done. The bottom or the point through which the piston can move, below cannot move, it cannot move. So the stroke, stroke is the linear distance between TDC and BDC, TDC to BDC distance stroke. Now the bore, what is bore? Now bore is the engine cylinder. If this is the engine cylinder, normally the diameter is termed as bore, small d. Generally it is in mm. Swept volume, now the swept volume means if we I consider this is the engine cylinder small, the portion or the volume covered by the piston, the volume covered by the piston, it is known as swept volume, VS. Now if we look, there is some portion that is uncovered by the piston, that is nothing but clearance volume, BC. So the volume that is uncovered, it is known as VC. Now VC can be calculated by subtracting total volume V minus VS. Now the compression ratio is simple, total volume divided by clearance volume is known as compression ratio. Piston speed is the average speed of the piston that reciprocate, so it is calculated by 2ln. L is the length of the stroke, n is the speed in rpm. If it is taken in rps, then the speed will be in meter per second. If it is in meter per minute or minute rpm, then it will be giving speed in meter per minute. So what are the processes inside the engine? There are four processes inside the engine. These two diagrams are shown, four stroke and two stroke engine. So suction is there. Suction is the simple taking of air and fuel inside the engine. Only air for the case of diesel engine and air fuel for the case of petrol engine. Compression is the simple compressing the air fuel mixture to the clearance volume. You can see there is compression in the first stroke, compression, then ignition. In this also, the first process can be taken with the fuel coming inside, compression, spark, this is spark ignition SI, this is CI, it is also SI, sorry. In CI there will not be any spark, there will not be any spark. So the third stroke is power stroke, by which we are getting the power. Exhaust is the simple removal of this gases through this path. So you can see there is four stroke coming inside in the left diagram, and we are having only two movement for the complete removal. So what will happen in the two stroke? There is a process called scavenging. Scavenging. What is scavenging? Scavenging is the simple removal of exhaust gases through the pushing force of inlet. That is the scavenging process that is taken. In four stroke we are having valve, in two stroke we are having ports. One is inlet port, the second one is exhaust port, the third one is transport port. This one, the part, this one is the transport port. Okay. Now what will happen if we put diesel in bike? Now if you see four stroke and two stroke comparison, so two stroke will have more speed, more power, but the efficiency is less. Speed is more in two stroke, power is more, but the efficiency is less. In case of four stroke, we are having less power, less speed, but the efficiency is more. So four stroke petrol is normally used in our vehicles, bike, scooters, etc. Four stroke petrol. Four stroke diesel is used in truck, Bolero, Scorpio. Two stroke petrol engine was used in ancient time scooters. Okay, two stroke petrol is used in marine engines, ship, faster bike, speed bikes, racing bikes, that is. So the question is, what will happen if you put diesel in bike? If diesel is applied to a bike engine, what will happen? That engine will be damaged partially or fully, as the ignition temperature of diesel is 210. That means diesel will burn at temperature 210, while petrol will burn at 247 degree. That means the engine will have the heating effect earlier. That means it is not designed to bear that much of load, so engine will be damaged. Now what will happen if you put petrol in truck? The engine will not start. As we know, diesel does not need any type of spark as while petrol need. Petrol does not have any spark in the truck, so it will not run at all. So the temperature, there will be engine clogging, engine will shut down, the engine will not start at all. So this is all about the prerequisites of IC engine. Thank you.